Hey guys, so in my Cove update review video, I was a bit dismissive of Soul Kinship, saying that it's not as good as people think. So I want to clarify why I said that, because that's not at all a bad skill. It's just that I don't think that is the solution to the problem people think it is. And since I didn't want to make a video just for that, I'm actually going to talk about all the kinship skills, but also all the stats that we have surrounding kinship. So first off, let's talk about the ways to generate kinship. So the main two ways are to win a head-to-head, which will grant you 25 kinship, or to win a double attack, which will grant you either 20 or 30 kinship, and we'll talk about it later. So those are the two biggest ways to generate kinship. However, you have other ways. You can pet your monster for 15 kinship, you can heal any member of the team for 10 kinship, and any attack that is not a special attack from you or your monster will give you 5 kinship each. And finally, when an enemy is below 50% HP, you will get a special showdown. The showdown is the mini game during the fight that you have to press a button really fast. And if you win this, you will be granted 50 kinship. I believe that the biggest reason why people struggle with kinship generation is because when you do a lot of SR dance, whether it's with the AI or someone that you don't know, it's possible that you get unlucky with the head-to-head and you're not able to generate any kinship. And I think that's the reason why people are using soul kinship, but I don't think that's the best skill for that specific situation, and I'm gonna explain you why. So there are four skills to help you generate kinship. The first one is soul kinship, which at max level increase the kinship generation by 30% on everything. The next one is head-to-head master that improves the kinship generation by 40%, but only on head-to-head. On a side note, a head-to-head is different from double attack, so this will not work on double attacks, only on head-to-head. Then we have critical kinship, which every time you do a critical hit, you get 25 flat kinship. And finally, we have partner that increase your kinship generation by 50%, but only when you're half health. The first thing I can tell you is that partner for me is the worst skill of all, because you need to be below 50% health and the increase of kinship generation is not that significant compared to other skills. So if you have the choice, I would never use partner kinship. So now that leaves us with three skills. And again, if you have the choice, head-to-head master, I believe, is worse than soul kinship. If you have head-to-head master, you will generate one or two more kinship on a head-to-head than if you had soul kinship. However, on everything that is not a head-to-head, you will generate zero additional kinship, whereas with soul kinship, you will benefit from those 30% all the time. So if you have the choice between soul kinship and head-to-head master, I would always, always, always go with soul kinship. Now, if head-to-head master is for free on your charm or your armor, then it's still a very decent skill. On top of that, soul kinship is the only skill that works on double attacks, because head-to-head master only works on head-to-head, and crit kinship only works when you do a crit, and you cannot crit on a double attack. So it looks like soul kinship is the best kinship generation skill in the game, so why was I dismissive of it last time in my video? Well, soul kinship is indeed a very good skill, but it does not help solve your problem of not having enough head-to-head in SR dance or with random partners. Yes, you have a 30% boost to kinship, but this boost is going to be applied to very low value, so petting your monster or doing a basic attack. So you probably noticed that I left out critical kinship and I did not talk about it. Well, I believe that it's because it's the best way to generate kinship when you don't have any head-to-head. If you take the Rajang armor set, which has weak point XL and critical M, this set alone gives you 37 critical chance. Using a whetstone that gives you an additional 15% critical chance will bump this up to 52% crit chance. And usually, Southern Shields have about 6% crit chance, so you will have about 60% crit chance with this set. If you go crazy, you can even use the Nagakuga Southern Shield, which gives you 15% crit chance, and that will bump you to 67% crit chance, which is very high crit. So let's look at this clip for example. I'm using this exact set, and I use a whetstone on turn 1, so I'm at 67 crit chance right now. Now, I want you to focus on my kinship bar. I'm gonna do a normal attack with no head-to-head and look at how much my kinship goes up. It's a very significant amount, and I don't need any head-to-head to make it work. And on round 3, I just switched to a better weapon for this fight. This gives me a very good baseline of kinship to finish the fight. Now on the next turn, I still don't have a head-to-head, and I'm gonna use a weapon skill, which consumes my kinship. And look at how much kinship I gain anyway. So that's a very good way to generate kinship without head-to-head. Now there is a second way, and I think it's more fun, and you can even pair the first way and the second way to have very good kinship generation. This second way will require that A, either you have a real friend that you play with and you can talk to on the mic, or B, if you play with the AI, you have to look up for opportunities to use it. But basically what the game doesn't really explain well, I think, is that you can use each other's monsters to do double attack between each other, and both party will gain kinship. Okay, so let's pause the video for a second. Earlier I said that when you do a double attack, each party will get 20 or 30 kinship. That means that if you do a double attack with your monster, both you and your monster will generate 20 kinship, so that's a total of 40 kinship. Now if you do a double attack with your partner or the AI, you will generate 30 kinship per party. So you will generate 30 kinship and your partner will generate 30 kinship. So it's a bit less than if you are doing a double attack with your monster. But there is two benefits to it. The first one is that everyone gets kinship, and the second one is that now your monster is free to do whatever, so it can buff or it can attack the monster. Now there's two ways you can do it. The first one is you, the rider, can combo with your partner's monster, or you can get your monster to combo with your partner's rider. It will all depend on who gets the head-to-head. In this case, I get the head-to-head, and I see that my AI's monster is doing a speed attack, which is the right move. So I decide to combo with my AI's monster. So if we look at the clip, we see that we do a double attack and both party get kinship. The reason why I say that you need communication or someone you can talk to is because if you decide to do a double attack with your monster, this has priority. So your partner can try all they want to combo with your monster, it won't happen. So if you play with someone random online that will not let you combo with their monster, you will never be able to do it. So that's why the first method with critical kinship can work better for you. On a side note, the mounting charm that you get at the village pot that gives you 30% kinship generation is exactly like soul kinship. It's the exact same buff and they stack with each other, except it applies to both you and the monster. So if you're struggling to get head-to-heads with randoms and the crit kinship method is still not good enough, you can try to add the mounting charm for added benefit and it may be able to do it for you. So to clarify what I said in my KT review video, soul kinship is not a bad skill, that's not what I meant. I think it's a very good skill if you use it for what it is. But I think if your issue is to not have enough head-to-head in some cases, give a try to critical kinship. I think it may be better than you expect. But that's it for me today. So I hope you liked the video. And if you have any questions, as usual, leave a comment in the comment section. All right, see you next time.